Hey guys, welcome back to the video of Creatnprocess. In this video, we'll be designing a sticker and we'll look at how to create multiple instances of the sticker in a single A4 size paper so that it can be printed out. So first of all, I'll just drag in a sketch which I have drawn for the design. So here we got the text. So here it is. And we'll just scale this down a little bit. So I'll just select this and with a shift and alt press, just scale it down and place it there in the middle of the artboard. Let's zoom it in and let's lock this. Command 2 or Control 2. Now let's trace this out using the pen tool. So I'll use the pen tool and let's trace this out. So first of all, we'll trace it out in a basic form. So for now, let's trace it out. Done the basic tracing here, let's do the detail stuff. So we'll give some clean and nice roundy shapes to this design. So let's do the details. So we'll start from here. Let's look at this. I'll just combine everything and Control C. Control F to paste in front and let's place this inside this. Okay, now if you look at it, we can see we got a nice thickness. We can reuse the thickness from here. Let's check it out. Okay, how much thickness you want to give, you can just play around with that. And after that, go to Object, Expand it. Now we have completed our text design. Next is we have to create the background design. So I'll go to folder and just drag in our, here it is, the background sketch. And this time we'll just place it there. And I'll just scale this down a little bit and trace this out. So Control 2 to lock it, or Command 2, and use the ellipse tool and draw out a circle. Let's type out our text also. So to do that, I'll just duplicate this Control C, Control F, and just scale it up a little bit, this much. And what I'll do is I'll just cut it off into half. So with the scissor tool selected, let's cut it from one from here and other from there, and we got two pieces now. Selecting the top piece, we'll leave it the text tool selected, and the text option should be text on path tool. Click over here, and after that, let's type out our text. In the same way, I'll just select this other piece, text tool, click over there, and let's type out our text. So this one is LIFELONG lifelong practice, practice, practice. And this time we'll use the die selection tool. Let's drag it and place it like that. And to change the upside down, we have to click on this small icon, and if you drag it up, you can see now it's there. And after that, let's scale this up a little bit and place it there. And for now, let's leave it like that. Now let's fill it up with the color. So I choose a color from here, and it's any color like that. And we'll fill this up with the CMYK color. So I have got a color for this. So this one we'll be filling up with white color. Let's leave it like that. The other one, the second one, we'll fill this up with some color. And I got a dark faded blue color. So for that, I'll choose fill it up with the CMYK color. So I got a value 72, 54. 55 and 32 and click OK. So we got that color. The third one, I'll choose some color, and for this we have a light orange color. So to do that, I'll just choose some, put up the value for that again. So 162, other one is 100, so maybe 0 and 00 and last value 0, and click OK. So you got that nice orange color. In the same way, the last piece, so this one will fill this up with light blue color. So here we go. So let's fill this up 25, 1, 16, and this one is 0, and click OK. So we got these colors. Once you have got all these, let's select these pieces, remove the fill color. Not the fill color, the stroke color. That's all. Now let's give some effect. So I'll select this one and go to effect, stylize, drop shadow. And here we got these values in millimeters. So it's fine. If it wasn't in millimeter, we can do the changes by going to selection tool, preferences, units, and you can change the value from here. So for now we need millimeter, so it's fine. We'll use that. So selecting this, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow, and here we'll preview it, and we'll give the values here 0 by 0, this one also 0, and for the blur value, let's give it around 0.5, so 0.5, let's check it out. And I think it's great. We can reduce it a little bit more, like giving 4, and let's see, that's fine. I click OK and let's leave it. This one again, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow, and apply the same color. So apply it, click OK, and we got that nice effect. Selecting this, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow again, you got that effect. So click OK and you got it. So we got that nice depth here. This one we can do some adjustments. So selecting these two, let's select this control, selecting these two, I'll just scale this up a little bit, and we can increase the font size like that. That's great. And let's change the font color to the white. Okay, fine. Now once you have completed this design background, let's bring this up. So arrange to front, bring it there, place it on top. Now let's do the placement. So I'll just scale this down a little bit and let's place it properly there. Great, it's looking great. This one we can do is we can reduce the font size because it's covering up almost like that. Okay, and this one we can just push it a little bit on the right side. So select only this one, and with the die selection tool selected, you can see this, just push it a little bit this side and you can see this. Now after that, you can read it. If you want to do the for the top one, selecting that with the die selection tool selected, just push it a little bit upward and you can see that. So once you have done that, let's fill this up with the proper color. So I choose for the background color this one, white, and let's remove the background color. So control alt 2 and delete it. Well, now we don't need that, and I'll just place it a little bit here so you can see it. Now let's do some stuff. So here we can see it's looking flat, so let's give some drop shadow. And to do that, I just duplicate this Ctrl C, Ctrl F like that. And this one, what I'll do is I'll just give some drop shadow, but it shouldn't be on this here, but it should be inside that. So with a clipping mask option, we can use that. So I'll do is I'll just give some effect to this first, stylized drop shadow, preview it, and you can see that effect, nice effect, drop shadow effect. And what I want is I want some more effects. So if Windows appearance, and let's do the adjustment. So where is it? Here's a drop shadow effect, preview it, and let's increase the blurriness. So I'll just increase it to 8 and let's see. Yeah, that's all. Now if you check it out, the drop shadow is falling all over, but I don't want on this. It should look like it's one object. To do that, I'll just duplicate this, selecting this one, Ctrl C, Ctrl F, arrange to front, and I'll just remove the drop shadow effect, select this and this, and make clipping mask. And this way you can see we got that nice effect. And this way we'll select this and arrange to front. Now our design is ready. Let's set up a document so that it can be printed out. So I'll set up a new document file, new, and here let's set up a document. I'll give a name STICKER sticker, and I'll size A4 size, make it vertical, then millimeter, and click OK. So we got a new document. Now let's drag this design inside this new document. So I just drag and drop there. So we got a design on our new document. Now let's resize the design according to our size we required. But before that, let's expand this. So go to object, expand appearance, and this way if you scale it up or scale it down, you wouldn't lose this effect. So I'll just scale it down now, Ctrl G to group it, and I'll just scale this down. So you can see we have the same effect which you have applied without losing anything. So next we need to adjust the size. So we have to give some size so that you can which size you want to print it out. So we'll give around 100 mm. So let's give 100 mm, and the height will be proportionately like that. And now let's place it there. But before that, we'll give some crop area. So to give that, we'll go to effect and crop mark. So we got that crop mark. You can even adjust the crop mark by expanding it, object, expand appearance, and this way you can ungroup it, and with a direct selection tool selected, you can do the adjustments like this. So you can just move around like that and it will be done. Now you can even add the bleed area. If your design is like rectangular, you can add some bleed area. Go to object, path, and offset path, and this way you can add extra area to your design, and it should be applied only to the background. So we select your background, rectangle background, and apply it, and it will create an extra bleeding area. But for now, I'll not apply for this design. I'll leave it like that. Before placing that, let's give some save zone. So I'll go to view and let's show print tiling, and this way you can see that the print tiling area, this is the safe zone. You have to put all your design content inside this rectangle. So select this and I'll just place it inside this like that. And after placing that, I need to create instances for this. So first of all, group this, Ctrl G like that. And now I'll go to effect, distort and transform, and select the transform option. And you got this palette here. You can preview it, and let's give one copy. Let's increase the horizontal. So let's increase it. You can see you have we are creating a duplicate, one duplicate here. So just drag out, give some value so that you can give that effect. And let's see that it doesn't cross that area. So increase it proportionately. Just increase the value slowly, and you can see. Okay, if you got that, and now once we are happy with that, just click the OK button and your duplicators will be ready. In the same way, you can create few more. If you want it diagonally, you can just go to effect, transform, transform, and apply new effect. Okay, and preview it, And this time we'll just uncopy one copy for this again and just give some value to this vertical. So we'll be creating a few more like that. See, two more objects has been duplicated very easily. Okay, and let's leave it like that. So if you check it out, so we got four stickers with the crop area, and if you move the main object, it will move along with that, like that. And if you give any changes to this main object, it will be applied automatically. So these are the instances, and if you want to check it out how many objects are on the artboard, you can just click Ctrl Y and you'll see there's only one object there. Ctrl Y and came back, and here it is. Now let's show you how to do the changes. So if you want to do changes, like you want to change some color, let's change some color. So I'll just ungroup it once, and selecting this, I'll just go in there, select this piece, and let's change the color to something like, let's say you like some light blue, maybe like that. And I'll just copy this one, Ctrl C. Okay, let's get back outside. And this one also will change the color to that. So just apply it there, Ctrl V, enter, and selecting the background again, going there, Ctrl V, enter. And if we come out again like that, you can see it's applied to all our design, and it's very easy to edit. You will edit the main and everything will be edited, and you can easily print it out. So, and one more thing, that's you can save this effect. So to save this effect so that you can apply it in your future projects, you can do the easy stuff. So if you check it out, selecting this appearance palette, you got this group. So this is the effect here, and you want to save it, go to Windows and graphic style, open that palette, here it is, just drag it out, open the appearance, and by clicking this, just click and drag there, and your effect is there. Just double click on that, give the name like you want to give. So I'll just give like sticker effect, so that's S-T-I-C-K-E-R, sticker, and enter. So you got to see that this group has been changed to sticker, and here's the effect. So if you create new style, if you create new design, and you want this effect, like you want instances within second, you can just select that and click on this style, and it will be automatically created. So it's become very easy. So finally, we have created our design, and we have learned how to create instances, and you can just directly go to File, Save As, and Save As PDF, and save like that. And you got this PDF palette here. Under this, just do all your stuff, like printing. For printing, you want the trim marks and you don't want it, just leave it blank and click save the PDF, and your PDF will be saved. So here's the PDF exported out with a crop mark, and you can directly print it out, cut it out. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and don't forget to check out our website for the articles which I have written on for this design, behind the scene, and lots of other stuff. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.